4 months after Hurricane Irma ripped across the Caribbean with devastating wind gusts topping 220 miles per hour, the island of Barbuda remains nearly deserted. This 62-square-mile island in the eastern Caribbean is one half of the twin island nation of Antigua and Barbuda. Antigua is home to the national government and has 80,000 residents, while Barbuda's population, at least prior to the storm, was just 1,600 people. A mandatory evacuation, prompted by a second hurricane just days after Irma, left Barbuda uninhabited for the first time in 300 years. Electricity and water have yet to be fully restored, leaving the roughly 500 people here largely relying on power generators and other donated supplies. The NewsHour caught a ride with Nikki Jeffrey, a mother of three, as she and her family made their way toward home.
This was my living room, my bedroom, my kitchen. We were actually in the house when the wind started and everything. We went into the bathroom. And this is what saved our lives. We're all standing here watching the roof just evaporate. Everything's flying off.
The same day Nikki Jeffrey visited her home, the Prime Minister of Antigua and Barbuda, Gaston Brown, was in New York at a high-level donor meeting for hurricane-ravaged Caribbean nations. The United Nations estimates it'll cost $79 million to rebuild Barbuda's housing stock, and that total recovery costs for the island could reach $220 million.
These individuals are displaced in Antigua. They have no homes, so they are homeless, they are jobless. In many instances, they are helpless.
The donor meeting raised $1.3 billion in pledges from the international community, but Brown says he will not be able to just hand out money to Barbudans to rebuild their homes.
I have no doubt that the international community is not going to foot the entire bill of $222 million. And we do not have the capacity to borrow $222 million.
So to secure finances for rebuilding their homes, Prime Minister Brown has made a controversial proposal to Barbudans.
If we borrow to build properties, then clearly the homeowners, they have to have some skin in the game. So whereas we will heavily subsidize these mortgages, they must be title given to these individuals, and a mortgage taken on the property to make sure they pay.
The only problem with the Prime Minister's plan, Barbudans don't have land titles and have collectively owned their land since Britain abolished slavery in its colonies in 1834.
In Antigua, they don't have common land, communal land ownership. But it is something that we are culturally tied to. It's something that historically for 300 years, I mean, we're descendants of slaves, and it's something that we have fought for. And then in 2007, it became law as well.
Unlike Antigua, Barbudans can own land without a property title because land ownership is controlled by the community through the Barbuda Council.
Barbudans own the land in common. You can get three plots of land. One for residential, one for commercial, and one for agricultural as a Barbudan.
However, in the wake of the storm, Prime Minister Brown's government is seeking to overturn a 2007 law that recognized Barbuda's communal land system. Nikki Jeffrey and more than a dozen other people we spoke with all opposed the Prime Minister's plan, money to rebuild and mortgages in exchange for communal land ownership. Prime Minister Brown says he respects the sensibilities and culture of Barbudans, but ultimately, it is their choice to accept his mortgage plan or not.
Those who wish to continue to occupy the land, we're not challenging them. They can continue to live in common as associate, that's fine. But those who require title so that they can rebuild, my government will give them that option.
This leaves Barbudan homeowners in a tough spot. They must accept land title or rebuild on their own. Historically, Barbudans have built their homes incrementally and relied on savings rather than bank mortgages. Few, if any, have insurance. The reason? After the last major storm, Hurricane Luis in 1995, a fraudulent provider failed to make good on claims. Further complicating Barbuda's recovery picture is the Antiguan government's rush to develop the island for tourism. Unlike Barbuda, Antigua, with its all-inclusive resorts and cruise ship docks, has long been a major Caribbean tourist destination. Some Barbudans fear the end of communal land ownership may pave the way for the sell-off of lucrative tracts of the island. John Mussington, the headmaster of the island secondary school, took the NewsHour to see land being cleared for a new international airport. The timing of this construction angers many locals.
From where I live, west of the hospital, I could see the lights in the sky and hearing the scraping of metal on rocks and so on. Here were people using the opportunity that it did not have the population on the ground to ask questions, and they're hurrying day and night to clear what they could clear.
And right over at the point,
George Jeffries took the NewsHour to the site where actor Robert De Niro is seeking to build a luxury resort, a development that has stirred controversy among Barbudans ever since the government signed a lease with De Niro's company in 2015.
All these lead me to the conclusion that they are persons who are bent on getting cheap land to speculate on real estate.
It's still too early to know how much of the pledged $1.3 billion in international donor aid Antigua and Barbuda will receive, or if Barbudans will take the Prime Minister's offer of land title. But for residents like Nikki Jeffrey with school-age kids, the burden of living life between two islands is wearing thin.
They went back to school on the 23rd or somewhere around there of September in Antigua. And, well, they're catching on good, but I want to come home. I need to come home.